gnocchi first, and then we're going to make the entire dish. Is that what our plan is? It's with pecorino, I know that. And it's in my book, At the Table of La Fortessa. I said it right. So let me talk to you a minute about gnocchi. So people are very intimidated about making gnocchi, but they're really easy to make. They're fun. It's a really good family thing to do. I used to do it all the time with my family. In Italy, there's a couple ways you can use, or you can mash the potatoes. You don't need a ricer. You can just literally mash them with a potato masher. These have chestnut flour and regular flour. And this is chestnut flour. This is very much from the region. So I'm mashing the potatoes up. They're smooth, they're mushy. Yeah, so see how mushed up that is?
So it's 1 cup of chestnut flour.
Very good. Always sifting the chestnut flour.
Same.
Really important.
How you call it? Grumi.
Lumps.
Lumps.
That's what you call it. What do you call it in Italian?
Grumi.
Grumi, I like it. What did you just put in?
A little bit of salt and 2 eggs.
I was just gonna put it in and you like scared me. Go,
no.
Bye. What else? What is this?
Eggs, two eggs.
Yeah, we just want to be clear that it's eggs. And then we add flour. Leo sifts everything now. Blending is super important. So you need a lot of flour. It's in the recipe. Don't be afraid of the gnocchi. You know, people are afraid of this dough, but it's a really, once you get it incorporated, it's a really easy dough to work with. And you know, it's not precious, so you can make boo-boos and, you know, put it back together again, because there's no real, it's not a really gluten-based, it's more potato-based than gluten. So now he's cut it up into 3 workable pieces, 1, 2, 3, and you have to have a lot of flour around you. And then once he starts rolling it out, he'll roll it out to a very thin, he and I have different size things, like we like different size gnocchis. He likes a thicker gnocchi, I like a thinner gnocchi, so I'll show you my gnocchi, he'll show you his gnocchi. We'll show each other our gnocchis. So do you cut yours up into little pieces?
Sure.
But you cut yours up into really thick pieces, like the gnocchi we had another night, they were like dumplings. So gnocchi to you are like big? No, I'm being
this
serious. That's not. This is Leo's and this is mine. In the book, it looks more like this. This is in Leo's book, apparently. I think these are gnocchi. So what you want to do is you want to roll it like this on this board. And you can like shape it so it's got a nice little, you just want to roll it back and forth. In the book, they're gnocchi, but they're like this. They're not the big, giant, chunky. No, they're not. We're arguing about nothing. This is what we do all day. We just argue about nothing. Like an old married couple. I think we've been working together too long, personally. I think it's over. We're leaving. Enjoy the videos we've made. We're done. We're done working together. So you can also use the back of a fork, right? So you can just roll them on the back of a fork. Either one works. Don't listen to him. Listen to me. Okay. So we're just going to make these. It's going to take a minute.
Annette, the mushroom guys. We need to go. We cannot stay here. We have to go to see the mushroom guy.
Mushroom guy. Here you go. Bye.
Oh, yeah. The moon.
I would say Federico, if I had to describe him, would be what we used to say back in the olden days. It's very studly.
Hello, girls.
Ciao.
Wow. That is gorgeous.
I have these mushrooms for you.
Mushroom delivery. Yes, sir. So if anybody's wondering why I live in Italy, you'll have no more questions.
You want to grab them?
Should we? I do want to grab them. Oh, that's a big one.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's a huge mushroom. My God.
As you can see.
Oh, bello.
Wow. These are big.
These are new.
These are amazing.
Yeah.
Gorgeous.
Bravo, Fede.
Wow. Is that the sound it's supposed to make?
Yeah. It's like a drum kit.
So cute. It's like a drum kit. This guy is a mushroom hunter, ski instructor, massage therapist,
and DJ.
Oh, and a very famous DJ. So as my son says, he's a meme of a man. And I agree. All right, should we take these in the kitchen?
Yeah.
Will you carry them down? Full disclosure, I called Federico for mushrooms. We were preparing zero mushrooms during the filming. Yeah, look at all these beautiful mushrooms.
But there are no mushrooms in this recipe.
I know. Continuing the recipe, we have made the gnocchi. And once you've made the gnocchi, you can just put them aside. And then we're going to chop up some, what is this with kale, but this is a different, it's not kale. What is it?
No, it's chard.
It's like chard. Oh, it's with chard? Oh, God. The recipe's with chard. Sorry. But you could make it with kale, honestly. Any green will do, yeah. I mean, let's not get hysterical here. Again, substitute things you like. My cookbook is just a guide. This looks like a lot, but it actually cooks down to not a lot.
Getting a little hungry here.
Okay.
A lot of cooking, no eating.
Okay, get out and we'll bring you your lunch.
Okay. Looking forward. Looks yummy.
Okay. Get out. Okay. So my husband Frank has joined me. He's usually at La Fortessa for maybe a month, but broken up like 2 weeks and 2 weeks. He is now a retired hand surgeon. And he is living with me full time. And I'm just gonna say the word challenging. Okay, let's move over here because we're gonna saute this stuff up. Again, a lot of salt, a lot of water. That's for the gnocchi. It's very important that there's a lot of salt. It should be like the sea. That's what I always say, salty sea. So here's the thing about gnocchi. So you can eat gnocchi, you can take it right out of the water and eat it, or you can saute it, which is what we're gonna do here. I prefer to saute gnocchi. Do you prefer to saute gnocchi?
The chestnut gnocchis, yes, for sure.
For sure. They're really quick. What, do you think they're like maybe 2 minutes, the gnocchi? Not
less,
even?
Less. When they are floating, they are ready. So you can put directly in the pan.
Because we're using chestnut flour, it has like a really nice nutty quality. And so when you toss them in butter and you brown them a bit, they're really delicious, they have a nice bite. Let's see, they're browning. We're gonna let them brown. They're gonna get brown. Like nutty brown. Well, we're cooking here, Michael. This is not fast food. It takes a minute to make gnocchi. Is that a problem? It is. So we're just gonna cook this off for a minute and we are gonna finish it off with more olive oil, of course, and salt. And then we'll just do shavings of pecorino. And yeah, then we're good to go. Oh, this looks so good. Can I taste it? I can't wait. These are so cute.
Buono.
So good. Really good. You guys are gonna like this. Frank is gonna like this because he's starving to death. What is it, like three? It's like wilting away. And it's so like green. That's the thing I like about it. They do eat a lot of vegetables in this region, which I really appreciate. They eat a lot of meat, but they eat a lot of vegetables too. Do you want to taste it?
Can I try it?
Yes! I knew you were coming to taste this.
Yeah.
Do you mind eating after me? No, you don't. I'm like your mama.
Yeah.
Okay. You have to blow on it though. Blow. Oh, oop, oop. That's good,
wow.
Right? That's good. I love this. This is my favorite.
My dog.
I love it.
Very good. Thank you for trying it. Thank you for trying it. Thank you so much. Can we have him come every day? I think we need mushrooms every day. He's also a massage therapist. Okay, my people, we have done gnocchi painfully, but try this at home.
Don't try this at home.
No, don't try this at home. No, try this at home. It's really easy. With some chard, some pecorino cheese, a little bit of butter, a little bit of love. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you soon. Ciao, ciao.
If you like what you saw today, like and subscribe.
Do the DJ hand.
How can I do it?
You can.
Like and subscribe.